A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 30th October, on the front page you have European lawmakers begin visit to Jammu and Kashmir. So this is the news, the front page news yesterday too. So invite to members of European Parliament from United Kingdom was rescinded after member of parliament asked to meet people without escort. Means he wanted to meet people independently. So he was not allowed that. His invite was cancelled. And questions are growing over NGO's invite to members of European Parliament. So a prestigious VIP meeting with Prime Minister Narendra Modi has also been assured by the NGO that organized this visit. Then below you have India Saudi Arabia constitutes strategic partnership council. So this is again what was there in news yesterday regarding a strategic partnership council which will be formed. So India Saudi Arabia have formed this council. Prime Minister Narendra Modi is in Riyadh, Saudi Arabia. He addressed the Future Investment Initiative Summit there. And this Justice Bobde appointed next CJI. So the name was suggested by the Chief Justice of India, the senior most judge of the Supreme Court, and the government has accepted it and he has been appointed as next CJI. Then this is again regarding Delhi, the air quality dips. And this is no cyber attack on Kundankulam plant. So this is a rumor which spread. It was claimed on Twitter that the Kudankulam nuclear power plant's domain controller level access could have been compromised. So, cybersecurity experts made such claims, but officials deny that the site was hacked. So, this is a cause of concern. If nuclear power plant's domain controller level access could be hacked, then it is a serious cause of concern. It can result in a huge disaster. You should know about this. On page 2, you have JNU students protest against draft hostel manual, lock dean's office. So this is JNU Students Union. It terms changes in rules undemocratic and demand withdrawal of this draft hostel manual document. So these changes which have been introduced in this manual are like imposing a curfew on students, increasing hostel fees, enforcing dress code and barring students from participating in protests. On page 8, you have top official summoned in Valayar case. So, the National Commission for Scheduled Castes has summoned Chief Secretary Tom Jones and Kerala Police Chief in connection with the rape and death of two minor sisters at Attapallam near Valayar, in which all the accused have walked out scot-free. So, the acquittals by POXCO court has caused a furor. There were widespread protests against the failure of the prosecution and the alleged role of the government and some ruling party members in weakening the case. And below you have Telangana RTC strike enters 25th day. So trade union leaders claim no employee has reported for work so far. And here you have renovation of 13th century temple to begin soon. So this is 13th century Lakshmi Narasimha temple in Bhadravati of Shivamoga district in Karnataka. So this was built during the Hoysala period and has developed cracks and seepages. So renovation would be undertaken here. It's a Trikutla, which is a temple with three shrines. So it's dedicated to deities Lakshmi Narasimha, Venu Gopala Swami and Purushottam. On page 9, you have 36 million Indians face flood risk study. So, number of those affected may be underestimated, but this is a study which has been undertaken which shows that 36 million Indians face flood risk. So, flood may face flooding by 2050 and 44 million may face flooding by 2100 if emissions continue to rise unabated. This is a study you can see. This analysis suggests that globally nearly 110 million people living on land below the current high tide lines and 250 million on land below annual flood levels are at risk. Then below you have make my trip OYO face antitrust probe. So Competition Commissioner of India has ordered a detailed investigation into online travel booking companies Make My Trip, Go IBIBO and hospitality provider OYO based on complaints by members of Federation of Hotel and Restaurant Association of India alleging deep discounting, payment issues and cheating by these firms. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Brotherhood Unbound. So this is regarding Sena BJP talks in Maharashtra after the legislative assembly elections. So the editorial says that Sena's brinkmanship in talks with BJP is unlikely to fetch it dividends in Maharashtra. So Sena has been adamant on its demand. It wants 50-50 formula to be applied for seat sharing. It wants the CM post also for half the term to be for Shiv Sena leader. And here you have deep traps. So this is regarding abandoned wells. So the onus of closure of abandoned wells should be on the local body and not the owner is what this editorial argues. So we have seen such wells where kids have fallen and it can turn out to be life threatening. Then the lead article is piecing together the Maharashtra mandate. So this is again regarding politics. So, missteps by ruling alliance, it is said, rejuvenated a moribund opposition and a maze of social identities are now resurgent. And this is the new gold standard in development economics. So, it says with the randomized control trials for which the Economics Nobel was awarded to three researchers including Abhijit Banerjee and his wife Esther Duflow along with Michael Kremer. So, this randomized control trials have become a dominant factor. So, it says randomistas could be changing the social science paradigm. So, this is a new standard in development economics which is detailed out. So, this is very important, randomized controlled trials. On op-ed page, you have legal pluralism in personal law. So, it says uniformity in civil law can only be achieved in a piecemeal manner. So, uniform civil code cannot be suddenly applied to all, but it can be done step by step. This is what is discussed here. This is also very important because the BJP has been adamant on having uniform civil code in the country, but how to go about it is detail is important. And this is India's Afghanistan conundrum. So it says the US's current policy in Afghanistan puts India in a tough spot and Pakistan in a good place. So this is India's concern because USA has been keen on taking Pakistan's assistance in resolving the Afghan issue. You know, it wants to move out of Afghanistan and negotiating with Taliban. It wants Pakistan's help in that, USA. So India is in a tough spot in that scenario. India has also made investments in Afghanistan and wants to be a key stakeholder there. Then this again, there's front page news and again regarding India-Saudi Arabia relations. So the two countries condemn terrorism. It says no particular religion, race or culture should be linked with international terror. So this is the joint statement issued by the two. And also MOU that will help Hajj pilgrims to travel comfortably in Saudi Arabia during pilgrimage season has been cleared. So there are other MOUs which have also been signed. And this is sharp fall in number of Pakistanis visiting India. So, Bangladesh is now make up the largest block of foreign visitors to India. Pakistani visitors have drastically fallen. And this is also front page news continued, which is very, very important. It says Kudankulam plant control systems are hacked through. So, officials say it is not connected to a network or internet. Then on international page you have House to vote on impeachment probe. So US House of Representatives is going to vote on impeachment probe. So this is a change in strategy. So this was announced by the Speaker of House of US House of Representatives. The House will hold a formal vote on the impeachment inquiry. And this is Islamic State after Baghdadi. So his death is a blow to Islamic State, but insurgency is likely to continue. So that is what is spoken of in this news analysis. Then on business page you have Indigo soars with $33 billion A320 new order. So, 300 plane order is Airbus's largest ever with a single airline. So, Indigo has placed such an order. And below you have automobile sales witness Diwali boom. So, it is said up to 50% jump in private vehicle retail sales has been seen in festive season. Even discounts were given. And this is government to work on relief package for telco. So, we have been seeing the troubles of telecom sector. Yesterday too, it was in news regarding AGR, the adjusted gross revenue verdict of the Supreme Court as such too. So, industry stares at over 1.4 lakh crore payout to exchequer, to the government. So, telecom industry is in stress. So, government will work on a relief package for them. And this is Adani US Group to set up data centers in India. So, Adani Group along with US Group, will set up data centers. It will utilize infrastructure developed by Adani. So, this is the plan you can see. And below you have RBI slaps 1 crore penalty on Bandhan Bank. So, this is a penalty for violating licensing norms. Bandhan Bank has earlier also been in news. The bank started functioning as a commercial bank in 2015 and was to comply with RBI norms by 2018, which it failed to do. So, this is very important. You should know about it. It has been prominently in news earlier too. So, it has been given a universal banking license. And on the last page you have Assamese Bhavna to make an English debut in Abu Dhabi. So, three siblings are taking this folk theatre of Assam to global audience. So, this is Bhavna, you should know about it. With culture perspective. And below you have mountain gorillas in Africa rebound thanks to careful intervention. So, this is mountain gorillas now are again, conservation steps being taken so that they can survive. So, it says change could not have happened without an exercise some biologists call extreme conservation, in which monitoring every single ape in the rainforest was undertaken. So, this is regarding biodiversity conservation. So, that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asha.com. Thank you.